Morning students, the aim for today's practical is to demonstrate the SOXLIT apparatus. This apparatus is used to carry out the extraction process of the various crude drugs. Like we have already studied that there are different extraction processes which are used to prepare the extract, which includes maceration, decoction, digestion, infusion and percolation. So this is the main apparatus or the laboratory apparatus which is most commonly used for carrying out the extraction. And the principle which is involved in the SOXLIT apparatus, that is hot percolation. That means the extraction is carried out by using a solvent at a raised level of the temperature. And during the extraction from any crude drug, that crude drug is first converted into the powder form so that we can increase the surface area that will come in contact with the solvent that is used for the extraction. So the assembly of the SOXLIT apparatus, it looks like this. It is having different parts like condenser, extractor, RPF and the heating source. So here I will show you all the parts of this SOXLIT apparatus and how to assemble it. So this is the condenser, or we can call it as a deflux condenser, and this is the SOXLIT apparatus, or you can call it as a extractor. So in this extractor you can see that it is having two tube like structures. This small tube is known as the siphoning tube, and this tube of large diameter is known as side tube. So the extraction which is carried out in using this SOXLIT apparatus, that depends upon the siphoning, means how much siphoning and how many siphoning are occurring in a one cycle, that also affects the extraction process. To assemble this SOXLIT apparatus, firstly there should be a heating mantle, that is a heat source which is connected to the power source, and then we take the RPF in which the solvent is poured. We select the solvent depending upon the nature of the crude drug from which the extraction is going to take place, and we select that solvent in which the constituents from the given drug, they are soluble. So at the top of the RPF or at the mouth of the RPF, we attach this extractor, which is also known as the SOXLIT extractor. So by applying or by lubricating this mouth of the RPF, we insert the extractor into the RPF. And further, at the top of the extractor, we insert this condenser. So there are two points. Like here, we give the water inlet. It should be attached to the water source so that the water can take entry through this port, and from the upper port it is the water outlet. So during the process of extraction, we make use of the stand so that it can hold the condenser while performing the extraction. So during the extraction process, when the water source is attached over here, then before placing the drug into this extractor, we convert that crude drug. Suppose we are taking the leaves of the ficus, and we convert these leaves with the by pressing between the hands into a coarse powder just to increase the surface area. And to pack this drug, there is a procedure that we have to put a small amount of the cotton into this extractor, and with the help of the glass rod, we have to insert that cotton into the, with the help of the glass rod or spatula, we kept the cotton at the base of this extractor, and then we pack this drug into the extractor. The drug can be directly packed into this extractor, or it can be packed in a thimble which is made up of the filter paper, or we can use the muslin cloth for the packaging of the drug. So after the transferring of this crude drug into the extractor, we again put a thin layer of the cotton over it so that the liquid after condensation that will fall over here that will not disturb the equilibrium or the uniformity of the packed crude drug. So after packing the drug, we attach the condenser over here and then we start performing the practical. So when we start the power, the heating mantle, it starts getting heat and the solvent that is taken in this RBF that gets vaporized. So when it gets vaporized, the vapors from the solvent, they rise upward and they enter into the side tube. They travel through this side tube and raises to the upward direction, and here there is a water inlet and there is variation in the temperature. So these vapors, when they try to rise up, due to the lower temperature they get condensed, and during the condensation they fall down and they touches the drug that is packed in the extractor. So the level of the solvent that keeps on rising, and when it reaches the maximum level of this siphon tube, then all of this solvent that is condensed that goes back into this RBF through the siphoning tube. So this is known as one siphoning. So this process is proceed in a continuous manner. We have to continue till 5 to 10 siphonings or 10 to 15 siphonings, that is selected according to the nature of the drug. So this process takes a long time, like 48 hours to 72 hours, depending upon the nature of the constituents or depending upon the nature of the crude drug that is selected. So this is a continuous hot extraction method which is used to extract out the active chemical constituents from the given drug. Thank you.